What up, guys? Welcome to today. Playing some more WWE 2K16 Universe Mode, part of Friday Night Generations, part of the Not Universe Mode series, episode 16. Fucking hey, things have been crazy this week here on Universe Mode. This is not Universe Mode, but still part of the week on the season. Sorry to confuse anyone. What I'm trying to say is, shit's been crazy this week in Universe Mode. We've seen Pure Intense Wrestling, Crash Pimp Wrestling, and Divas, where just matches have just been surprisingly gotten better. And as we get closer and closer, every second, every fucking breath that I take is one step closer to that game. 2K17 is coming out so much quicker than I thought it could. You know, where I'm right now, I'm in September. We're in September of this year. It was September 1st, is to tell you how much to date this video here. And it's just gonna get crazy. Shit's getting crazy, and we've seen people go out of their minds to make sure that they win and get themselves championships. We've seen people get injured all of this week. We've seen people just fucking go to work this week, and Friday Night Generations is no different. This is what these guys and girls do here tonight. It's all about what these guys and girls do here every night. Let's see how this whole night goes on. As always, if you haven't seen Crash Man Pro Wrestling, Pure Intense Wrestling, or Divas earlier this week, please go back and check it out. If you've missed previous episodes of Not Universe Mode, please go back and check those out as well. They're in playlists. They're in descriptions. It's all below. Click the description below. You'll see all the links. I have everything posted there. Everything is updated every damn time I upload something. So if you want to see something, or if you feel like you missed something, if you want to watch everything in all one day, whatever you want to do, it's all in the description below. Please check it out. You may also find other things that are wrestling related in those playlists as well. With all being said and done, though, let's get it on here with Friday Night Generations here tonight on episode 16 of Not Universe Mode. Up for Sami Zayn, Hideo, Tommy, and Kalisto take each other on in the triple threat match. You guys know who these guys are already. You guys already know how good these guys are. Let's see what they can do. Let's see which one of these two can get a win here tonight. Sorry, three can get the win here tonight. Second match, Nikki Bella takes on Eva Marie. I'm in this petition. I want people to sign it. Petition to make Eva Marie great again. Crickets. Yes, I know, but I have a plan for Eva Marie to make her better, and I want to have that continue going on into 2K17. I have plans for this girl. The question is, can she compete and can she make herself great? Can she make herself great? We'll find out soon enough. She takes on Nikki Bella here, who's been a former Divas champion, and now wants to work on towards that women's championship as well. The question is, can she do it? Nikki Bella, no joke in that ring. Let's see what she can do against Eva Marie. Our third match of the night, Brock Lesnar takes on The Big Show. Brock Lesnar's been on control as of late. He's been throwing everyone around. He's doing whatever the fuck he wants to do. He's been making sure that he is the best in that ring. He wants to get himself very close to that World Heavyweight Championship. He doesn't care if it's Triple H, Samoa Joe, or whoever else it is. He wants to make sure that he has that belt around his waist soon enough. And the way he's rolling right now, it just may be sooner than you think. But he takes on The Big Show here tonight. Big Show's not going to give him an easy night. These two have taken each other on before. It's been way back in 2004 and back in 2005, all that good stuff. They were beating the hell out of each other here. They were beating the hell out of each other, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Brock Lesnar got one on Big Show. Big Show got one on Brock Lesnar, back and forth. And I want to see what these guys can do here tonight. Can Brock Lesnar keep his streak of dominance going, or will Big Show take him down a peg? We'll find out later on in our third match of the night. Our fourth match is for the United States Championship. United States Championship of the World. It's for United States Championship as Rusev takes on Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler earning himself that United States Championship last week against Baron Corbin, and now he wants to keep that belt around his waist. The question is, can he do it versus Rusev here? Rusev does not have Lana out here to have any kind of distractions. He's here to do it by himself. He doesn't need Lana out here. He says she can stay in the back. He can do this on his own. Let's see if he can win that championship. Let's see if he can do this thing here tonight. We'll find out later on tonight in our fourth match. Our fifth match, Ric Flair takes on Darren Young. Ric Flair trying to better these kids. Darren Young and Titus O'Neil, where Batista could give a fuck less as long as he's holding that belt around his waist, one half of that tag team belt around his waist. Ric Flair also holding the other half that WWE tag team championships around his waist. But the question is, if Darren Young can get a win here tonight, would that really throw Ric Flair off? Because they've been damn near close to winning those championships before. If Darren Young can really take Ric Flair off his game, hell, you never know what can happen in the future with those championships. Our sixth match of the night, I can't count, is Shawn Michaels taking on Seth Rollins. These two keep on just trying to outdo each other and are outdoing each other here. Shawn Michaels seems like he has one over on Seth Rollins, but then Seth Rollins out of nowhere would get a win over on Shawn Michaels, and back and forth and back and forth. We'll see which one of these two can get a win here tonight. And in our main event, Samoa Joe, the newly crowned World Heavyweight Champion, takes on Triple H. These two take each other on. It's been a while since we've really seen these two in action. It's been about 2 weeks now. I believe last week Samoa Joe took on Finn Balor and got a win over Finn Balor, and Finn Balor pretty much gave it his all. But I think Triple H is now ready to get himself back in the game here. Pardon the pun of being his nickname there, but really wants to get himself back in this thing here and get that championship back around his waist. The question is, can he do it? The championship is not on the line here tonight, but a win for Triple H would be huge in the momentum going towards Triple H's favor. Can he do it? Or will Samoa Joe keep that dominant streak going? We'll find out later on tonight in our main event. But up first, Sami Zayn, Hideo Itami, and Kalisto take each other on a triple threat match. Let's get to it. Here on Friday Night Generations. This is our first match tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my gosh, already Sami Zayn. Oh, going for a kick. Forearm shot there by Kalisto. Kalisto's throwing a man with that snapmare. Kick right to the back. Nice soccer ball kick taken down. Hideo Itami here. Already Sami Zayn. Trying to throw forearms and everything here. Oh! Going for his own forearm there. Oh! Hideo saw it coming. Oh, kicking him on the side of the arm there. You saw that, the way he took him down there. Oh, both of them going for the same thing here. German suplex there by Hideo. Already, this match has gone out of control, and this thing just started. Now Hideo has him where he wants him, setting up for that. Oh, nice reversal there by Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn, one of the most technically savvy men we have here in the whole WWE, and that says a lot. Hideo throwing those fucking strikes there. Oh, he got him. Flying. Oh, and he lands right into Kalisto there. Hideo on fucking... has everyone in control here. Going up to the top here, but not paying attention to Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn with the ends are going to take him down. Stopping that streak. That momentum that Hideo was on for the last moment here. Oh my gosh, no. No! Big guys are pulling out their biggest moves here early on. This one could easily be over for one of these guys if they keep going the way they are. And they can maybe outdo themselves at the same time. Kick to the back there. Oh! Both guys trying to go for something there. Clothesline there, taken down. Oh! A slap right to the face. Dale going for that low drop kick. Sami Zayn swats it away. Sami Zayn now with a chop to the chest. Big time chop. Hideo trying to roll into the outside here. Kalisto flying, but so is Hideo. Sorry, Hideo flying back into the ring here. This. Oh! Key crusher there. Beautifully done. Surprised Kalisto still standing at this point. No! Dropkick swatted away. A triple threat if there was one. These guys are getting it going here. Kill a kick right across, kicking him in the midst. Hideo's in the way and he's kicking over Hideo. That's amazing. Oh, look at this. German suplex lands right in the back of his neck. And Hideo was trying to run for Kalisto there, trying to get something going, but same thing, it cuts him off. Hurricanrana, beautifully done. Frankenstein, to be more exact. Just looks at him there. Oh, ducks the clothes on Hideo. Every time trying to go at him, Hideo's not very exactly the small guy like the rest of the other two are here, but at the same time, not quiet by any means. It's flying straight at Kalisto. Kalisto very quick to get things done. Oh! And very quick to reverse out of things too. Tossing Kalisto into the corner, throws him down, and does the same thing right there again to Sami Zayn. Drop kick taking down Kalisto now. Hideo now in control. Saito suplex that belly to back suplex, beautifully done. Kick to the midsection there. Oh, spinning heel kick right across the face. Look at this body splash, beautifully done there by Kalisto. So showing off his athletic ability and how high he can get. Got very high on that splash as well. Breaking up the pin quickly is Sami Zayn. Wasting no time trying to get things done here quickly. And Hideo Itami just may have this match in the bag. Setting up that go to sleep. He got all of it. Kalisto might be out of it here. Referee, one, two. No, and Kalisto kicks out of two. Enziguri taking down Kalisto. I'm surprised how Kalisto's still standing at this point. Missed that drop kick. Get him in a lot of trouble here. Oh, misses it by just a little bit. Oh, swatted that hand away. Arm drag reversal there. Forearm shot, saw it coming all the way. Swinging neck breaker, toss around the back of his neck. Kalisto takes advantage of that, takes him right back up, going for something big. Possibly, look at this. Oh, right to the fucking head. Sami Zayn, crowd screaming lucha, 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 but this is not where, where Kalisto wants him to be right now. Another one of those fucking kicks right to the face. Reversal there by Kalisto. It's back and forth with all these three here. The hell else can... Oh my gosh, Sami Zayn do at this point. Not Sami Zayn, Hideo Itami. Except for that Falcon Arrow there. Kick to the fucking leg. Another one. Pulls him into the corner. Hideo fights out of it. Hideo throwing everything he can at this point. Big time punch throwing him back though. Oof. Blast both men out at this point. Reversal there by Kalisto once again. Sami Zayn right back up in into it too. Oof. The hell else can he do? Look at this. He's packaging him up for a package. Throwaway power bomb, package driver. I don't know what it is, but Tommy is in the corner here. He makes the save. Just as I said that. Sets up with something big. Go! Oh, snap suplex. Hideo, part of it. Oh! Hideo does not want to be out of this match by any means. Don't want to be half, don't want to be a semi part of this. He wants to be full in this, and he has been in part of it since the start. Look at this. Blue Thunder Bomb, beautifully done. Kalisto trying to get up here. Oh! He kicks out before it's too late. Damn near close. Blue Thunder Bomb taking him out. Kalisto knows that he's going to try to take advantage of this now. Kicks out of that quickly. Sami Zayn now, focusing on Kalisto. Kick to the back of the hamstring there. These guys are going for something. Tell it's double team maneuvers here. Oh my goodness. The hell else can he do? What the hell else can Sami Zayn do? We'll find out soon enough, won't we? Look at this. Back rotating suplex. Oh. Kick him right in the chest. And now Sami Zayn may have this one in the bag. We'll see what he can do. Kalisto trying to do something to get himself back up. Back suplex there by Hideo. Look at this. Beautifully done with that fucking weaving through with that neck breaker there. And Sami Zayn quickly, desperately trying to make that save. No. Kalisto now. That's Hurricanrana. This roll up here. Oh! Crowd screaming Hideo. Crowd screaming Hideo. Hey, look at this. Oh! Cleans around on the back of his neck. But the only thing it may have saved him with that rope break. All these guys are battered and beaten this point. This is an amazing match here so far. Oh! Fucking European uppercut. Blue Thunder Bomb there. Oof, misses it. Makes the save. Ooh. Again, they just blast him with that. Oh! Kalisto just blasts him with that punch. Just may have knocked him out there. Kadeo flies right into the spine of Kalisto there. Kalisto's still getting up, but you gotta believe he's dazed. I think he hit him right where he wants to hit him. And Sami Zayn now focusing on Hideo Itami, who's down. Now Hideo says, no, I give a fuck less about you. Cesaro passing by my home there, ladies and gentlemen. No. Those punches, that's where exactly where Hideo wants to be right now. This is exactly where Hideo wants to be. Oh, goodness. Back kick taking him down. Same thing goes for Kalisto there. We're kicking him right back down too. Trying to get this one-sided match going here for himself. Oh, Dale breaks his fucking fall there. German suplex once again. Adele's not 100%. Kalisto's not 100%. Sami Zayn not 100%. But these guys are still getting it going here. Oh! Hideo Itami has him where he wants him. The question is, Sami Zayn gonna allow him to pull this off here? Looks like he wants to let him do what he wants to do. Momentum definitely going towards Hideo here, though. Look at this. Oh, he flies right into a suicide dive. Holy shit. Oh, I don't know where he was going, but he knocked the referee out for a momentarily here. Either way. So with that brain buster, he got all of it. Oh. Seth's up with that, go to sleep. And he just may have it here. Oh. Hits it all. Referee, this could be it. 1, 2, 3, this one is over. Hideo Itami, holy shit, he knocked him out so hard, his back of his head was laying on the bottom rope there. Knocked the hell out quickly. This match was amazing as far as start to finish. Very kind of a broken triple threat, but either way, it got done. It was a match that was fun to watch either way. Great match, great fucking triple threat match. All these three guys doing their thing. Hideo Itami waiting and abiding his time. I mean, the referee and everything, the timing was perfect practically for Hideo Itami there at the end. Back and forth between these three guys, and this is all I wanted to see was a kind of match like this where these three guys who know each other well, these indie darlings, are fucking bringing it here. Hideo Itami with that fucking go to sleep. This is early on in the match, and we thought it easily could have been it. This easily could have been it, but it wasn't just yet. Right after hitting that brain buster, fucking gets him up, sets him with that GTS, the referee getting up just in time here, big time knee right across the fucking bottom jaw, and has Sami Zayn knocked the hell out there, and he gets the 3, and this one is over. Hideo Itami back in control here, and I'm wondering if this guy wants to get himself a championship shot. I'd love to see this guy with a championship around his waist. The question is, can he do it? We'll find out soon enough, but man, doing big things right now is Hideo. Anyway, guys, up next, we got some more action for your asses. Some women's action for your asses, to be more exact. As Nikki Bella takes on Eva Marie. Can Eva Marie become great again? Or will Nikki Bella keep her awesome amazingness going? I don't even know. Anyway, that's matches up next. Get ready for it. Some women's action for your asses on Friday Night Generations. This is our second match of the night, ladies and gentlemen. These two are going to bring it here. See the size comparison there. Eva Marie is no small girl. I mean, by any means, she's thick, she's big, she's no small girl. And Nikki Bella is not going to allow it to be too easy for her, though. The experience definitely goes towards Nikki Bella here, but Marie's that slight size comparison may just help Eva Marie in the end here. We'll find out soon enough. Oh! Eva Marie throwing her fucking body around. She knows what she's doing in that ring. Referee to five here. And everybody's ready to fucking go. Going back in the ring with both these girls. Go! Oh! Don't taunt Eva Marie. Eva Marie not having any of it. The crowd booing away. They hate Eva Marie by all means. Eva Marie is not exactly a wrestler. Some would argue with. Some would say she's just here because she's cute. Some would even argue that she may not even be cute. In my honest opinion, I believe Eva Marie has the chances of just as about as any other person, or deserves a chance just like any other person does. Very young. Much like a Paige or any other younger divas that you see coming through. Not only young by age, but young by how good they are in that ring. Very green are these girls still, as good as they may be. Look at this. Oh! Nikki Bella takes her up with a chicken wing and tossed her right on her face there. Look at this. Oh, shit! Eva Marie with a bow and back into a girl right there. Holy shit! Just knocking the hell out of Nikki Bella there. Sets up for something. Look at this. Oh! Waste no time going for that pin. One, two, only two. Eva Marie bringing it as much as she possibly can. And like I said, Eva Marie has that size advantage there. And you see, Nikki Bella is no small girl by any means. She's not a small girl. And when you see Eva Marie stand up to you like that, and look, you can see the size comparison here. That's just the size altogether. Marie is no small girl. She's gonna use that size, she use that little bit of height to maybe get out of a submission, or use that weight to use it on Nikki Bella here and throw that weight across the chest of Nikki Bella later on when it comes down to going for a pin, a lateral press, anything to keep the shoulders down. Eva Marie may go for that. You never know what to expect. And Eva Marie, as green as she may be in that ring, she's bringing it to Nikki Bella right now. Oh! Playing a little dirty here is Eva Marie. Like I said, you may not like the girl, but she's bringing it as much as she possibly can. Going for the pin here once again. Push the fucking palms across the chin. And push the other her other arm across one of the elbows of Nikki Bella to keep her down here. Taking too much time, though. Missed that forearm and got caught with a hat suplex. Nikki Bella now taking advantage and stomping right under the chest of Eva Marie here. Has her in a headlock. I don't know what exactly her plans are. Look at this. Oh! Takes a lot of force to do something like that the way she did it. And they're going right for a lateral herself here. No! Kicks out it too. Fighting, trying to fight back. You saw her try to throw a punch there. Nikki Bella is a little bit more quicker and a little more knowledgeable in the ring on that exchange. Takes advantage of that. She's springing on the top rope. I don't know what Nikki Bella's plans are, but I'll tell you what, it's not going to be good. Oh, she has an Tree of Woe instead. Just stomping that face in there. Sets up. Oh, that Bella Buster. Big time signature move there by Nikki, but that's not it just yet. That's not it just yet by Nikki, but either way, going for another lateral press here. It'd be very lackadaisical pin. And just when she thought she had it, Eva Marie says, no, not just yet. Oh, forearm shot to the face. I don't know what Nikki Bella's plans are, but I'll tell you what's not going to be good. Oh, it tosses her over. Nikki Bella hangs on. Dropkick right there. Very, wouldn't expect it from Eva, but she's bringing it. The girl's bringing it for sure. I'm telling you, she's bringing it. Sets up for something. Oh, a spine buster. Holy shit. This may have taken the breath out of Nikki Bella here. Oh, that elbow across the face. Eva Marie getting back in the ring. All right, after her opponent wasting no time trying to stay on her here. See the way if she even picks her up is very green. Oh, a kick to the leg. Toss her on the top. I don't know what Eva Marie's plans are from here, but I'll tell you what, it's not going to be good regardless. Putting her up to the top rope. We just going for a suplex of some sort here. She's busy a bad spot. This would be a bad spot. Both these girls here, big time superplex. Fucking A. That could be it right there. Referee, again. Two. No, she kicks at a two. Oh, Shining Wizard just may have knocked her the hell out there and going for another pin here. One, two, and again kicks out of two. It's frustration being shown there by Eva. You can't really see it up from that angle. Regardless of such, Eva Marie wants to set up that stand. Sure, no way. That could be it right there. She got all of it. Pokes the leg once again. Referee. Two. No, and Nikki Bella again kicks out of two. And everything that Eva's throwing at Nikki, that resiliency that Nikki has is keeping her in this thing. Keep her in this thing constantly here. Another kick to the fucking midsection and throws her right back down. You saw the first, you see the restoration shot that coming from Eva Marie here. Forearm shot to the face. Kick to the midsection. Pick that to her midsection. Reverse that forearm, swatted it away. Sets up for something big here. Look at this. Eva Marie with a fucking reversal here. Nice sunset flip out of that. Referee, one, two. Oh, and how close was that? How close was that there, ladies and gentlemen? Sets up, schoolgirl pin here, and the referee says only a one. Sorry, I saw it says a rope break. Says it's nothing but a rope break. Forearm shot to the face. Running out of full here, and another big boot. And again, going for another lateral press, but wasting too much time trying to even get to that point there. No, and again, Nikki kicks out. You see everything that Eva Marie wanted. Oh! You may not like Eva, but goddamn it, she's bringing it right now. But wasting a little bit too much time to taunt. That may cost her there. Snapmare there by Nikki Bella. Wrenching away at that back. Wrenching away at the back as much as she can. That surfboard stretch nicely done. Like I said, the experience goes towards Nikki Bella here, and it's being shown right now in this wear down submission hold. Those arms gotta be definitely feeling it, especially that back too. Set for a dragon screw there by Nikki Bella. Bella now needs to get her back up, set for something here. But Eva Marie, like I said, that size, using those strong legs. Ooh! Right for another lateral press here. One, two, and again kicking out two. May not like Eva Marie, but she is bringing it, I'm telling you. Oh, just disrespecting Nikki Bella. And whether you love or hate Nikki Bella, you gotta give her all the credit in the world for fucking being good. She's grown over the years. She's gotten better over the years. And as much shit as she goes through, she's a damn good wrestler. Right now, damn good wrestler. Maybe in a damn bad spot here. Standing sure, knew we out of the corner. Slice bread, whatever you want to call it. One, two, three. And this one is over. Eva Marie with a big time victory here. Making Eva Marie great again, and it starts here tonight. It's starting here tonight, and I think this, as this thing goes on, even the chance of Eva Marie winning championship gold may be closer and closer every time. You may love or hate this girl, but you gotta give her credit for staying in this one. Eva Marie bringing it. Since she's being better as the time goes on, but man, that was a match there for sure. Nikki Bella with that right there turned the whole tides of the match in one foul swoop and wasting no time. You see her quickly wasting no time going for that pin, but only a two at that point. We saw big time moves from both Eva, and even though Eva threw that fucking standing shuriken the first time, it wasn't enough. Nikki Bella right here going for an Alabama Slam, I believe, gets reversed right into a sunset flip, and not many people do it like that. I'm saying not many people do it like that. That was amazing that she almost got that. She almost got that, but it wasn't until this fucking standing shuriken out of the corner that she got it. That shuriken out of the corner, that sliced bread number two, whatever you want to call it, she got the pin. You may love or hate Eva Marie, but goddamn, she has brought it. And I believe that Eva Marie wants to be great again. She wants to be great again. It's possible. It is possible. Holy shit, was not expecting that at all. But it is what it is. Eva Marie with a big time victory here. Anyway guys, up next we have some more action for your asses as Brock Lesnar takes on The Big Show. These two are gonna fucking get it going. These two know each other fucking well. These well two known veterans in that ring are gonna get it going. We'll see which one of these two can do it up next. Can get a win here, up next, here on Friday Night Generations. A quick Divas match now turns into a hard-hitting style match here. These two get it going here. These two very well-known to... Oh, my gosh! There's not going to be any kind of strong holds here. It's going to get Smash Mouth dirty in this one with these two. As Brock Lesnar and Big Show take each other on here. Big Show getting up slowly. Oh! Brock Lesnar not playing around with a Big Show by any means. He wants to get things done. Oh my gosh, no way. Oh my goodness, Brock Lesnar. Wasting no fucking time here. Oh! Pump handle slam just throws his body down. And Big Show in one move turned this whole match around. He just got suplexed, back suplexed over the ropes there. How many people can do that? The referee, I think he's confused and not on that side, sir. Going for something big. Running power slam. Oh my gosh, jeez. Holy shit. Big Show hit so fucking hard. It's ridiculous. Brock Lesnar may not be able to get up in time. Maybe win this thing, get count out here. Big Show going right back on the outside. He may not like Big Show, but he's respectful enough to go back on the outside, but that may be the biggest mistake. Brock was just throwing those fucking MMA-style punches right to the face of the Big Show here. You see the bruises happening, welting right over his arms there. And Big Show says no, and one headbutt turns it back around once again. And it's like I said, maybe the biggest challenge that Brock Lesnar's faced here so far is the Big Show. Oh, that backbreaker. Referee had a 4, I believe, now to 5. Big Show getting back into the ring here. I think he knows better this time not to reset the count. But then again, Big Show does whatever the hell he wants to do. He is the Big Show, just like Brock Lesnar is the Brock Lesnar. Referee had a 7 here. Brock taking his time to get back in the ring. Not going to try and run back in the ring here, especially when Big Show's on the inside. Big Show using those hip attacks. Oh! I'm going to bell toss him across the ring. Oh, that kick right on the side of the head of Brock. Brock not having any of it, though. And again, this time, he got that sidewalk slam. Big Show just looking at Brock here, saying, what are you trying to do? This is my place. This is where I belong. This is where I go. Oh! Big Show always, no matter where he goes, is a dominant character. No matter if you have him on Pure Intense Wrestling, Crash to Pepper Wrestling, fucking anywhere. This guy's just a monster. Oh, and speaking of a monster, what a monster of a forearm shot crashing right across the forehead of the Big Show here. Look how strong Brock is to pick him up. Holy shit, he just tossed him back down with authority with that power slam, that power bomb there. 1, 2. No, and Big Show staying in this one here. Oh, a kick right to the spine. And you see usually most people will hit somebody and let the effect start to drive in and let that effect do its damage. Brock does not care. He just keeps going until his opponent cannot, and will either gets pinned up for a 3 here or submits or just gives up altogether. Oh! Fucking A. Brock is a goddamn beast right now. Big Show in a lot of trouble. Brock can give a fuck less. Double axe handle from the top. Brock's just a big character on his own there too. I mean, we know Big Show's big, but Brock Lesnar is just as big. If you take Big Show out of the picture here and put Brock against any other guy, I mean, Brock Lesnar is more than likely bigger than most other guys he takes on anyway. Oh! At the same time, Big Show's manhandling Brock Lesnar, but at the same time, Brock Lesnar manhandling the Big Show. And now going for something big. Getting a little speed there. Oh, went for a spear. You saw him try to kick him in the head to try and stop him. But that could be it right there. Referee, 1, 2. No. Referee arguing with the... Big Show arguing with the referee. This match is not over just yet, though. Oh. Going for something big. Big Show somehow, some way slips out of that as big as he is. And Brock, no dummy by any means, rolls off the other side here. Big Show going after him here. That's to be the worst idea that he can do. Brock, no dummy, rolls back into the ring. Knows he has the advantage here. Oh! Like I said, knows he has the advantage here and takes advantage of that power. Oh, what a power bomb there. Holy shit. Takes him into the middle of the ring. Look at the strength on this man. This fucking power bomb from the fucking ground. Oh my gosh, he has him in that Brock lock. That Brock lock. I don't know what you exactly what you call the technical name for that move, but the long limbs of the Big Show just helped him get out of that submission. And just a second is all it takes to really make someone tap out here. And now Brock Lesnar clobbering at the head of the Big Show here. These two big bastards are getting it going here, and I'm loving every minute of it here. Brock Lesnar toss him off, sets up for a German suplex here. Oh, that's one. That's one right there. Two. Going for a third. Three German suplexes. Brock looking like a goddamn hawk. Looking for his prey, and now setting up for the Kimura lock there. And when you have a big man down like that, this match can easily be over quickly. Referee, the crowd behind the Big Show here saying, "Let's go, Big Show." But how much does he have in him? You don't want to break the man's arm, and he has no choice but to tap. Brock Lesnar with a victory here. Holy shit! There was no F5 necessary. He just hits it with a fucking that Brock lock. If he didn't get caught with that Brock lock. Shit, that fucking Kimura lock does his damage. Move that he used back in MMA to really do damage to the guys back in MMA just to fucking wreck him up. And he's such a strong character too. You don't want to get caught in that when you do. You do not want to get caught in that. And when Brock, if Brock gets you in that, and more likely Kenny just manhandles you into it, it's a bad day. It's a damn bad day. Tell you what. Either way, though, Brock with a big-time victory. Big Show brought as much as he could, but Brock has just been on a streak of dominance as of late. And if anyone wants to get into the way of Brock Lesnar here, fucking try it. So far, men have tried, but it's not found a way to fucking take out the beast. This Kimura lock there, I thought he was going to go for an F5, but instead hits that fucking Kimura lock, has Big Show tap out, and as big as Big Show is, it's hard to get off the ground. Brock knows that, and grounded him with that fucking armbar, that a modified armbar, and fucking locks him in. Got that fucking submission done quickly, wasting no time, and now Brock Lesnar, ready to take on his next opponent, whoever that may be. Anyway, guys, up next, we have some more action for your asses as Rusev takes on Dolph Ziggler for Dolph Ziggler's United States Championship. The question is, can Rusev get a victory here? Can Rusev turn the tides of battle here for himself and get that United States Championship back around his waist? Or will Dolph Ziggler walk out here tonight with that championship? We'll find out up next here on Friday Night Generations. This is our fourth match tonight here, ladies and gentlemen. These two want to fucking get going here. Oh my gosh! And you saw Rusev go back for a second. Start back at a second there, and now Rusev in control of this match. We just saw Dolph Ziggler try going for a grab. Very respectful grab there to try and get things going. Oh my gosh, Dolph Ziggler turns it around. Drop kick right to the face. It's like Mark Ranello here. So like Brock Lesnar taking on the Big Show. And now Dolph Ziggler smashes that forearm right to the face of Rusev here. Jumping over quickly. Drop kick swatted away. Big time backbreaker there by Rusev. I don't know why I did that, but I'm having fun here. Oh, let me know if I should do an episode like that. That's why I sound like Mark. I love his commentary. It's always like very entertaining. It's something. It's special. It's one of a kind, you know. But let me know if I should do an episode like that. I'd love to do an episode like that. I could do a whole episode in that voice. It's actually easier than doing my actual voice for some reason. Anyway. Rusev right now has control of Dolph Ziggler here. And like I said, start of this match off, you saw Dolph Ziggler trying going for a very wrestling style to start this one off. But Rusev says, fuck that. He went back. You saw him cock the foot back there. Nice judo throw there by Rusev as well. But you saw him cock the foot back and throw his whole weight into that clothesline. He knocked Dolph Ziggler on the back of his neck there, and really has just been taking advantage of this match since the start of it. Big time knee there, that's fucking hard-hitting style there by Rusev, and just getting work done here. Oh! It should be a reversal on that into a DDT. I think that'd be cool as fuck. Going for the pin. Two. No. Oh, fighting back as much as he possibly can, but Rusev just throws a knee right to the face of Dolph Ziggler here. This match has not been going the way he wanted it to since the start of this thing. Like I said, that one move has turned this thing around here for Rusev, and Rusev's chances, every move that he pulls off, is getting him one step closer to that championship goal that he wants. And right now, may be able to walk away with it with this submission hold here. You never know, wearing down Dolph Ziggler here, and you saw how quickly he went right for it, pin, wasting no time. Dolph Ziggler kicks out before the referee even fucking throws his hand down. Now, if Dolph Ziggler was not saying that Dolph Ziggler was dumb, but if he was smart, he'd go for something. He'd take his time on those pins and kick out maybe at two. But at the same time, you don't want to risk that when you're Dolph Ziggler. Oh! Clothesline taking him down, and now Ziggler in control. The crowd behind Ziggler, they know how important this guy is to the world of wrestling. They know how important he is to WWE here. Oh, wears him down with that submission hold there. That front neck chancery there, having Rusev locked into that submission hold and wearing down the head of Rusev. Smart man. What the hell? Out of nowhere, Rusev just throws his whole body into that and now locks in that fucking nerve hold. Pinching away at the fucking that neck, the trapezius muscle of Dolph Ziggler there too. And really take the breath out of you quickly. Rusev's just playing around with Dolph Ziggler here. He wants to win that championship though. Oh, went for the fucking drop to the knee, drop kick to the knee. And Rusev says no and tosses him across the ring. Dolph Ziggler did a lot to get to this point. I'm telling you, he did a lot to get to this point here. Oh! He got him! Fame Master, beautifully done! Dolph Ziggler wasted no time. Sets up for that zigzag. He got all of it! And how quickly has this match turned into the favor of Dolph Ziggler here? How quickly has it turned into his favor here? Two! No! And he kicks out a two! The face of Dolph Ziggler tells a million fucking stories. The pitcher tells a thousand words on what you just saw there. And now Ziggler playing around too much. He knows he has control, but wasting too much time taunting. Not paying attention to what his what's going on with him right now. Close onto the back of the neck. Ziggler kicks away. Setting up. Elbow to the chest. Beautifully done. Rusev still getting up. This big bohemian does not know how to stay down, I'm telling you. Oh! But Dolph Ziggler trying to keep him down here. Rusev was in control of this match from the start. And now after that fucking Fame Master, we saw the fucking ties change here. But catches a knee. Does Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler now being tossed to the top. Rusev playing old games here. And now Rusev ready to toss him across the fucking ring. I don't know. Whatever Rusev wants to do is what he wants to do. And just look at this. Oh my gosh. No way! No way! I gotta stop. Anyway, referee, 1, 2, he kicked on it, 1. Rusev, you gotta watch this man. Oh, that punch right to the head, man, do it. Spinning heel kick, just knocking him out there. That could be it. And Dolph Ziggler kicks out at 1. And you see the face of Rusev saying, what the hell do I have to do? Running drop kick. Rusev in control this one, but then got caught. Oh my gosh, got caught up there. Sets up that elbow right across that chest, and now Ziggler in control once again. This is where he has the same signature and fucking ground move. I'll switch that one day. Anyway, setting up. Ducks over. Should I say jumps over? Oh! Oh, just hits him right in the ass. Trying to keep him down here. Ziggler may have it. Oh, you saw Rusev trying to set up. And as smart as Dolph Ziggler is, pushes him away from the ropes here. This could be it. 2. And Rusev kicks out at 2. Did you see him try to cock that foot back with that super kick? Just may have knocked this fucking face off of Dolph Ziggler with that in a matter of seconds. If Dolph Ziggler did not throw that super kick in a fucking second early, a second earlier, he just may have got caught up. You saw Rusev trying to run out of it again. You never know what the hell Rusev is going to do. Drop kick beautifully done. Ziggler going up to the top quickly. Up to the clock as he possibly can. Elbow drop lands right in the back. Holy shit. You saw Rusev not wanting to stay down. Just fucking may have got himself knocked out. Dolph Ziggler sees the opportunity here. This could be it right there. This could be right there. He elbowed him right in the back of his neck. And Rusev still kicks at it too. You see a battered and bladed Rusev here. And as Rusev still gets up slower and slower, he's still getting just as fast as Dolph Ziggler is. Ducks the line. Caught in the corner. Oh! Referee needs to get out of the way. He almost got knocked the hell out. Oh, accolade. Accolade being locked in. Accolade being locked in. And this could be a bad spot right here. This could be a bad spot right here for Dolph Ziggler. This could be a bad spot right here for Dolph Ziggler. Holy shit, this could be a bad spot right now. And Snow throws his face right onto the mat. Even though he let go, that could be easily it right there for Dolph Ziggler. Referee one. No, and he kicks out at one. You see the face on Rusev. You can see the bloody face on Rusev here. Pissed off. Yeah, I believe he's pissed off. Very close to winning that championship. He's been bringing it since the start of this match. There's nothing you can take away from that. No. Can't take anything away from Rusev. He's been bringing it since the start of this thing here. And now set up for another submission hold here. Look at this. Beautifully done. Keeping wearing Dolph Ziggler down. This is exactly what he wants to do. Let's go again. Ziggler getting up slowly. Oh! No! No! He just clobbers him with that elbow. And now Ziggler has time to play around. What a fucking match this has been, ladies and gentlemen. This thing has been crazier so far. Fame Master once again. Wasting no time, and wasting no time here. Sets up for the zigzag, but no, Rusev saw it coming. Oof. Look at this. Oh, DDT clop just planted him in the corner there. That could be it. Referee one, and a rope break. Rusev's leg on that rope there. So it's like we're playing no games. Oh, and next snap, beautifully done. Ziggler up to the top once again. This time, can he get that elbow? Can he get that elbow flush this time? We'll find out. Elbow drop right across that chest. You may love or hate Dolph Ziggler, but you gotta give him credit. He has been bringing it from the start. Bring as much as he possibly can, but Rusev saw coming and breaks him down. Breaks him down quickly. And oh my gosh, this could be a bad spot right now. Rusev ready to go. Rusev ready to go on that kick. That kick could take the head off of Dolph Ziggler here and end this match. We may have the new United States champion here. No, they blast him with it. Wasting no time to go for the pin either. Referee, one, two, three, and he got it. Holy shit, Rusev. I fucked up on the pin. It was a big, oh, I've been fucking up these pins lately this week. I don't know, this week has been fucking weird for me, man, on pins. Like, I've been messing up on good pins that are easily gettable, but I think out of all the pins this week, because the other ones are pretty huge, that one was relatively smaller than most. That was like one, like, that was like a good 10% more than usually when you're 100% beat. So I think that's doable. That's okay to miss that one. I think it's okay, but I also think I'm just losing my mind here playing this fucking game. You know what I mean? It's one of those things where, like, you know the next game's coming out soon, and you're like, oh my gosh. Like, I want to get done, but I don't want to rush it either. But at the same time, I'm just fucking up right now. Look at this fucking maneuver here. He just plants his head into the fucking mat. And just when you thought it was it, Rusev's foot touching that rope there. And that kick fucking got him. I missed that by just a hair. You guys saw it too. It's not like it's a far off shit. Fucking hey, Rusev with your new United States champion. And if anyone wants to take it off of him, shit, they better fucking get to it, because he's gonna fucking bring it to whoever wants to take that championship away from him. Dolph Ziggler with a big time fight here, but Rusev starting this one off the way he wants to start it off and finishes it off the way he wants to finish it off. Amazing match from both these guys, but we have more action up next, because up next, Ric Flair takes on Darren Young. Get ready for it. It's up next here on Friday Night Generations. So one-on-one match between Ric Flair and Darren Young, two halves of a tag team, of tough tag teams here, taking each other on. Ric Flair, one half of the tag team, world tag team champions right now with Batista, part of Evolution. Always talk about how Randy Orton wants to get gold too, but really haven't seen him in action, and I'm wondering if he's actually okay, because we haven't seen him in a long time. I mean, when's the last time you guys saw Randy Orton? Think about it. I haven't seen him in a while, but he's still here. He's still around, I believe. I haven't seen anything from him in the back. I haven't seen anything from him, but I'll have to see the guy in action soon. Right now, it's all about these two right now. Darren Young, also one half of former tag team champions with Titus O'Neil, the primetime players, and right now, playing no games is Mr. No Days Off, Darren Young. For Ric Flair, that has the experience by a long shot over Darren Young. You don't let his age fool you. Ric Flair is no dummy in that ring and will play dirty until the man is gone. And even when he is gone, he will still be playing dirty in our hearts, in our souls, or our whatever. Oh! Kicks him off. Oh! Missed that elbow. Go for it again. This time going for something a little different there. That's what we gotta do. Keep switching up on Flair. Flair learns as he wrestles you. You can't do the same thing to Ric Flair twice and think you can get away with it. Oh, leg drop. Beautifully done. Go over something here, but Ric Flair gets himself back on the up in the standing position. Uppercut taking him down. Oh, that thrust right there. Oh, going for that chop, that patented chop, and a chop of his own. Throwing punches at both these guys here. I don't know why Ric Flair's nose is like orange. You guys see that shit? Maybe it's just me. I don't know. Look closely. His fucking nose is like orange or something. Oh! Darren Young thought he had something going on here on Ric Flair. Darren Young was horribly mistaken. Oh! Shot to the chest, taking him down. Something I you see from Ric Flair, but as I'm telling you, these guys are learning. Go! Darren Young and Tesla are learning from a guy like Ric Flair. Ric Flair's teaching them, even though he's on the opposite team. Repeat what I said before earlier on, Batista could give a fuck less about who he takes on. He just wants to hurt people. Ric Flair secretly, I believe Ric Flair is just teaching these boys how to fucking become better wrestlers, how to become men in this ring. Oh, and a leg drop right across the fucking throat. And he may not be the kind of guy to train you to become the men in this ring or teach you how to become better in this ring, but I do believe that if you're not in the ring, you're not learning every time you step in the ring, even if you take on the same person again and again, that you're not doing it right. If you're not learning whatever you're doing, you're not doing it right. Right now, speaking of doing it right, Ric Flair just maybe doing it right with that knee, that padded knee. Feeling, look at this, he got all of it. Hooks the leg here on Darren Young. Is it enough there? One, two, no. This thing is getting crazier and crazier as this night goes on here. These matches have been amazing here so far. I hope you guys have been enjoying. And if you haven't been enjoying, please go back and... But if you've missed anything this week, please go back and check it out. As I said before in the opening segment of the video here. If you guys want to see anything, let me know what you guys fucking think. Let me guys know what you guys want to see. All that, just let me know. If you guys are enjoying this and you are new to this channel, please comment, like, subscribe if you haven't already. It helps me out so much. It helps me out so damn much. Look at this. Darren Young setting up. Elbows and leg drops. Forearm shot across the face. That's what this guy does. That's what this guy does. And Ric Flair's in a lot of trouble here. He got the much more, maybe even though he's younger, much quicker. Oh! Darren Young here. Darren Young, Mr. No Days Off, is always on the move. This guy does not slow down until the match is over. And now set up that gut check. He got all of it. Holy shit, that could be right there. That could be it right there. Referee, call it as it is. One, two, no. Ric Flair, no dummy, kicks out at two. Takes his time. Does not try to kick out at one. Kicks out at damn two. This is what these guys do right here. Ric Flair knows how to fucking stay in the ring, and also he knows his placement. The way he fell off the knees of Darren Young there, he know that if anything, he'd fall right into that corner where he could possibly even get a rope break if he needs to. There's so many damn things that there's so many different ways to win. Oh! Throwing that fist right across the fucking forehead of Darren Young here. Now going for that nerve hold. Fucking wrenching it in. Not a submission, but a wear down for sure. Definitely taking the blood circulation away from your head there. And as he does that, now switching it up and going for those legs. So Ric Flair does so damn well as he just goes after you. He finds different ways to get you. No, back suplex. Belly to back suplex to be more like that. Flair's been in control of this thing so far. And now just maybe able to finish with this figure four. Able to finish with this figure four here. He's been doing a lot of damage to that leg so far. And it's just so damn good at breaking you down with submission holds. Breaking him down as much as he possibly can here. Letting go of that, surprisingly. But either way, he's gotten him countless victories before. Now going for a pin to turn things around here. No! Ric Flair arguing with the referee saying that was a three. But referee says only a two. Oh! Oh, man. Snap mirror, though. Ric Flair not like that. Now wearing him down again, trying to choke him out with a fucking elbow. But now, speaking of elbows, being thrown into the sternum here by Darren Young. Short arm clothesline, showing off the strength here. Darren Young, very strong character. Don't fucking let his looks fool you. May not be the biggest guy, but I'm telling you, he's a strong bastard. Picking up Flair here. Oh, Ric Flair hits him. I don't know if you heard that. That was the fucking skull of Ric Flair bouncing off the chin of Darren Young there. Mr. No Days Off may be in trouble here. Look at this. No! Darren Young saw it coming a mile away. Oh! Tosses his shoulder right into Ric Flair there. And now setting up for that combination again. Elbow drop after that. Falling off after that. Leg drop. And then throws a forearm to finish. This could be it right here for Ric Flair. This could be it right here. One. Two, three, and this one is over. Holy shit. What a match. This match's been crazy so far. We still have two more matches to go, but this one was definitely a fun match to watch. It was not the best match I've ever seen in my life, but man, the pacing was just nice back and forth. Ric Flair owning a lot of this match here. Darren Young coming back with a big time move. Ric Flair turning it back to his favor here, almost getting a win with that figure four, but it wasn't enough just yet. Then we saw the combination strike that Darren Young has to go for, that leg drop, then hits it with a fucking elbow drop across the chest and then lands a forearm right across the face. I mean, this is what this guy does. This is what he does. And Darren Young wants to get that momentum for not only for him, but for his team as well. How much that will help him and Titus O'Neil get closer and closer to those championships once again. They have another shot at those championships coming up soon, and they want to be 100%. They want to not only be 100%, but at the same time want to be on top of their A game. Want to be on top of their A game to get a win. To get that, not only get a win, but win those championships as well. Daniel playing no games. Look at this. Leg drop. Elbow drop. And finishes off with a forearm right across the chest. I mean, right across the face. Darren Young. You never know if it could have been a kick out or not, but went for the pin anyway. Got himself the three. Mr. Nordy Days Off is getting it going. Darren Young in control. Let's see what Batista and Titus O'Neil can do next week. Been crazy so far. Let's see what goes on as the tag teams, these two tag teams keep going at each other here. Anyways, up next, Shawn Michaels takes on Seth Rollins. I mean, a match we've seen millions of times. It always seems to find another way to end differently every single time. We'll see what one of these two guys can do by the end of this one. Up next, here on Friday Night Generations. This is our semi event of the night. Later, ladies and gentlemen, these two take each other on, and oh, already getting started here. Like I said before, if you're not learning from each other, you're wasting your time when you're in the ring, especially when you take the same person on again and again and again. If you're not learning something and finding new ways to defeat your opponent somehow, some way, then you're really wasting your time. Right now, Seth Rollins wearing down Shawn Michaels here, doing a damn good job of that. Shawn rolls out of it nicely. Forearm shot taking him down, and already Shawn in control. Already Shawn in control here. Already Shawn in control. No! Seth now has him where he wants him, setting up for that suplex. Beautifully done. Oof! Another forearm shot taking him down. And Seth doesn't want any part of it, it seems. He's walking out here. This means a count out victory here for Shawn, and I guess Shawn's gonna take all the advantage of it, and will love to gloat and do whatever he wants to do. Referee counting, has no choice but to count here. Seth walking out, okay, give a fuck. I guess he doesn't care. I guess he does not care. You can see the face on Seth here. Guess Seth wants to walk this one. I guess he's gonna have this one via count out here. Not walking back to the ring, not doing anything of that sort. Just gonna get counted out, I guess. Shawn Michaels, I guess, has the win here tonight. Not much to record on this one. I mean, that was it. Pacing back and forth is Seth, and you think maybe Seth is like, what else can I do? I mean, sure, he got the win last week, but I think Seth is besides himself here on taking on a legend in the business, being Shawn Michaels here. Something that he's definitely looked up to growing up. You look up to someone like that when you're growing up, and now you're taking them on all the time. I mean, I don't know. I have no idea. Shawn Michaels with a victory, or an easy victory, I guess, here tonight. Shawn's not going to complain with an easy victory, but Seth needs to get himself together. Seth needs to get himself back in this thing. Seth needs to win and come back and with a clear head. We'll find out what happens next week between these two, but that was that. Anyways, guys, up next in our main event, Samoa Joe takes on Triple H. It's going to be crazy, and you guys already know it. It's up next, like I said, on Friday Night Generations and our main event. This is our main event here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, as Samoa Joe takes on Triple H. You saw Triple H move back as Samoa Joe came towards him. He already knows what Samoa Joe is all about. That grappling style that he has, that very strong style that Samoa Joe brought to the U.S. first before guys like Shinsuke Nakamura or any other person brought to the ring. Samoa Joe is one of those kind of guys to bring to the U.S. first. Samoa Joe has tons of experience, over 15 years of experience. And Samoa Joe right now is also the World Heavyweight Champion, something that he took off of Triple H, and Triple H is pissed of that fact that he took it off of him. Same time, Triple H is no joke in that ring, has spent just as much time as Samoa Joe in the ring. Oh! Doing his damn thing there. Back in WWE, owning the fucking company. Not owning it, but you know what I mean. Owning the company as in, oof! Making it his. Being the top dog for a damn long time, along with guys like The Rock, Triple H. Sorry, The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin. It was there at that time. Oof! The kind of guy you talked about way back when. Look at this. A hammer lock. He had him in a hammer lock and tossed him over. He had nowhere to go but down. Oof! Samoa Joe tossing him outside there. And what you don't want to do is get in a one-on-one with Samoa Joe in that style where Samoa Joe can really get things going for himself. You don't want to be in that spot. Oh! And Samoa Joe tossed himself on the outside. Right into right into Triple H here. Instead of Samoa Joe respectfully getting back to let him get in the ring, fucking takes him right back down there. And now Samoa Joe has him where he wants him, setting up for a Wheel of Death LA Driver. He got him beautifully. Beautifully done there. That could be it right there. Referee, call it as it is. One, two. Triple H gets at it too. Oh. Look at this. Triple H showing off his strength and picks him up with a gut buster, single knee gut buster. Now smashing that elbow across the head as he has Samoa Joe's head trapped between his thigh there. You don't want to be... Triple H is so damn strong. I'm sure you can fucking squeeze Samoa Joe's head like a fucking peanut. So you watch it explode. Triple H is so damn strong and brings it whenever he's in that ring. He shows off that strength as well. Oh, how close was that backhand? How close was that backhand? Triple H realized that quickly after realizing how close the backhand was to him. Fucking instant, with an instinct, goes right for a sidewalk slam. Two. No. Samoa Joe not usually missing that often, but either way, right now, oh! The fact that he missed that, and that was a mistake there on Samoa Joe, gave Triple H all the opportunity in the world to now have to take the advantage of it, now smashing those fucking punches right into the face, right into the forehead of Samoa Joe here. Triple H now tossing him into the corner. I don't know what the plans are here, but whatever Triple H wants to do is whatever Triple H wants to do. Oh! Oh, smart man Triple H. No, new. Can feel that Samoa Joe, especially almost somebody that's out about 300 pounds. You can hear him flying at you there. Oh, and quickly. Look at this. Oh my gosh. And right back up and into it, Samoa Joe goes. Samoa Joe flying to the top as quickly as he possibly can. And this can easily be a bad spot for both these guys here. Oh my gosh. Oh, crossover for Triple H, and Triple H is using that to fuel himself, and holy shit, pedigree from the top. Samoa Joe just may have out of it here. Triple H in control. Big time DDT, and Samoa Joe is in trouble here. I don't think Samoa Joe was expecting to have that happen to him. He was ready to go. He was ready to jump, and Triple H flew up, caught him with a fucking kick to the midsection, and got with that pedigree on the outside, which is just as much damage as he did on the inside. Samoa Joe very quick not necessarily think here, but no. Oh! Very quick to act, but sometimes not very quick to think. And with that, Triple H is not done by any means. Most people would have loved to get a count of victory here and easily could have there, but Triple H not dumb. Now Triple H not dumb by any means. Just goes right back after his opponent. Resets the count and goes right back after his opponent. That's the veteran instinct there by Triple H as well. Oh. You talk about a backhand. I told you, you gotta watch out for that. And he does. And now Samoa Joe blasting that fucking leg of Triple H there. Triple H had bad knees before. Samoa Joe will take advantage of that. See him looking, glaring at him to get back into the ring. STO takedown. Samoa Joe wasting no time to go fast. Senton, big boy style. Fucking hey, these guys are getting it going here. I'm loving every minute of it here. Tosses him into the corner. Oh, he got him with that enziguri. Fucking hey. Waiting for Triple H to get up here. Taunting Triple H to get back up here. Oh. Samoa Joe. No! Oh! Sets up. Takes him to the top here. Could this easily be it right this? Easily could be it. Muscle Buster time, and he got all of it. Hooks the leg, wasting no time. One. Two. No, and Triple H kicks out at two. Frustration being shown by Samoa Joe, but Samoa Joe's nose is not over just yet. Samoa Joe knows it's not going to be that easy. Oh, goes for that snap jab, but gets swatted away. Triple H takes him down with a snap mare. Choking him out with that big arm that Triple H has here. It's hard even to breathe, not even just through someone's fucking arm, but then the elbow pad as well. Somebody almost like being smothered. Oh! With a pillow, oh! Both these guys bring it. I'm loving every minute of it. I hope the crowd is too. The crowd on their feet for the most part. Oh my gosh, diving leg lariat. Just may have taken Triple H's fucking neck clean off there. Two. And Samoa Joe only gets a two. Joe's right back up just as much as Triple H is, but Triple H is fighting too. Snap jab. Forearm shot. Swatted. Going for it all. Go! A Samoan blitz, likes to call it. for a smack there. And a spine buster to fucking make things happen. Waste no time, Tony. Just gets it done. No! Samoa Joe kicks out at two. Sorry, kicks out at one. Samoa Joe, champion for a reason, champion for a reason. Now sets up. Now sets up a Triple H shot. Triple H shot. Samoa Joe reverses it. DDT got all of it. Samoa Joe up to the top again here. Oh! I think Samoa Joe was trying to jump, but didn't have enough energy to make that jump full. Whoa, roll up here, roll up here. This easily could be it. The referee a little slow here. Referee one. No, and he kicks out at one. Samoa Joe throwing that arm up to make that save. To make that save. Let's see what he can do. Triple H taking advantage. Spine buster once again. One. Oh, and he kicks out again at a one. Crowd screaming Triple H. Crowd screaming Triple H. But Samoa Joe screaming. Oh my gosh. Oh, what the hell was that? Crowd behind Triple H. But how much does that mean there? Triple H is not that Triple H has never been cheerful like that. But he's a bad guy right now. You think they would take that off? Oh my gosh. Look at this. Stun gun. Oh. Move that Steve Austin used way back when. Stunning Steve Austin. Oh. Another jab there. Oh, trips him up with that foot. Stomping away right now at Triple H. Had no idea what's going on. He's just getting stomped in right now. German suplex. Dragon suplex. And finishes it off. Oh! That cross arm suplex there. No! And Triple H kicks out at two. This has been amazing here so far. Oh my gosh, out of nowhere. You saw he's going to probably toss him into the corner for that Samoa with the muscle buster, but no. This match has been amazing. One, two. No, and he throws up that fucking two at the last moment. And we thought that was it for there for Samoa Joe, but Samoa Joe's staying in it. These guys going at it once again. Trying to find that opportunity, trying to find that spot, trying to find that thing. That one thing is going to really help them win this thing. Oh, and just like Ric Flair taught them, we learn. That's what I've been talking about tonight. This is all about learning here tonight. Goes for something big, but no stock coming to Samoa Joe. Nice fucking reversal there. Picks up Triple H now for something he wants to go for. But no, now Triple H saw it coming all the way. Nice reversal there by Triple H. Back and forth here. Nice fucking lateral press right across the throat. But Samoa Joe throwing up that arm. These guys so damn good. So damn even at each other. No. No. Fucking A. Forearm shot to the face. The hell else is going for? What the hell else is he going for here? Look at this. Go! Oh! Samoa's drop. Sorry, I was fucking sent on. What else can these guys do is beyond me, but they're gonna pull something off here. Going for another lateral press. One. No, and again, only a one. And Triple H is wasting too much time trying to get easy moves off here. But he's getting desperate at this point, and so is Samoa Joe. Toss him to that corner again, full fucking strength. Oh! Oh, man, Triple H, oh, come on. Mile away, kick to the midsection, though. Slap to the face. Another one. Crowding to that corner. Another one. Enziguri to the head. Holy shit, what a match this has been here, ladies and gentlemen. What a match this has been here, ladies and gentlemen. Sets up. He has a Nekokina clutch. Nekokina clutch. If he gets him back, yep. He got all of it. And right now, may be in more trouble than anything, than anytime possible here. Anytime possible, he just may be in trouble. Some Triple H Triple H in so much trouble here and has no choice but to tap. What a match this has been. What a match this was. That is what I'm talking about right there. Triple H and Samoa Joe learning from each other, getting better every time they take each other on. How amazing was that? Triple H not liking that by any means. Not liking that by any means. Ducks the clothesline. Punch right to the face. Another one. A third one. And tosses him right over the top rope there. What a fucking match this was. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what I'm talking about. These guys bringing it. These guys bringing it so much. Bringing it and giving it their all. And you guys, as always, comment, like, subscribe if you haven't already. I hope you guys enjoyed this night. This night started off a little and then it got good, and then went back down to again, and then it went back up to a fucking million. Amazing. Friday Night Generations is the reason why I do things like this. I do this thing not only for myself, but for you guys as well. If you guys don't want to watch Cause wrestle, this was mostly what this Universal Mode is about. It's for Cause and shit like that, or my own creations or parodies, as you guys see. So if you guys miss stuff like Pantrance Wrestling, Crash Man Pro Wrestling, or Divas, please go back and check that out. It's all mostly original ideas from myself or from people that are, I mean, most of them are parodies, like I said, but the names and the fucking moves and all that shit are very original, you know what I mean? So with that all being said and done, let me know what you guys think. Comment, like, subscribe, like I said before. And I'll see you guys on Pure Intense Wrestling. More shit to come next week. Shit's getting crazy, crazy, crazy. If you also, guys, let me know if you guys want me to do an episode as, what's his name? Mark Ranello? I forgot his fucking, I don't know his last name, but it's Mark, I think it's Mark Ranello. He does a freight that crazy. This has been Friday Night Generations, and it's been amazing. It's from start to finish. You know what I mean? I want to do that. So if you guys want to just hear me do an episode like that, with that like over the top voiceover, I can do that shit. I think that was amazing. This whole night has been just killer, and it's only getting better. Now Universal Mode keeps on getting better, and as I keep finding new ways to make these things better, It's gonna get good. It's gonna get better, get good. Other games, any other wrestling games you guys want me to play, let me know. I will fucking add them to the list of things to play. I have a few games already set up that I want to play that are wrestling related. I'd love to do them. You guys would let me know what you guys think, and maybe you'll see the game that you want to see. But like I said, you have to leave a comment, or I will never see it. Anyways, guys, like I said before, one more time, comment, like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys at Pure Intense Wrestling. Until then, peace out and good shit.